Nuttyitonline.com/livewire.
You're figuring out when it's go time, when do I start fidgeting for the belt, when do I try and do the one-handed bra bandit snap. See if I can just reach back there and get... Got it. There's the boobies. But I mean, yeah. Like a year or two, years into a relationship, do you still make out? We asked ourselves with our significant others. Mike, I don't think we asked you. Put that person on hold. We didn't ask you about Rick. You and program director Rick. You guys still make out? You and
Yeah, I mean, time to time.
Because you're the only person yesterday when this came up in the meeting that Scott was like, oh, God, it's been years. And I was like, yeah, we've stopped. And you're like, oh, man, it's been weeks.
Yeah, it's only been 2 years into the relationship now. So, yeah, you know, the passions are still running high.
Now, do you do it sober, or is it a drunk thing?
You know, you tend to do it more when you're intoxicated, sure.
Yeah.
God, you're only 2 years in, huh?
Really? It seemed like a lifetime.
That's
really
so fresh. You know, where does it must be go? So nice.
That's nice. I didn't have a baby yet. Yeah. Didn't take me 2 years.
Wait till you're 10 years in with a 2-year-old.
The problem is, though, like, once you get going,
see if you're making out,
you want more. It's hard to pull the brakes on.
Oh, but that's the point. Like, when you're in a relationship, you don't really need to pull the brakes.
Yeah, you can go ahead and start fidgeting for the waistband.
So,
even
so
get
it usually does lead to more, but A, are you even still making out people out there? And B, is it sometimes just a make-out session?
Jay, Forest Hill, good morning.
Hey, how's it going?
How you doing, buddy?
Hey, happy birthday, Scott.
Thank you, brother.
Hey, Jay, we're talking Frenching.
Yeah, you guys French?
You French?
Still Frenching?
You do hot French?
Yeah, I've been married 5 years, and we got 3 kids.
Yeah.
All splitting. Yeah, it still happens. Actually, the other night, we were on Netflix. We're rewatching Sons of Anarchy, and she went out and got us ice cream. When she came back, we were sitting on the couch, and, you know, I was just rubbing her shoulder, you know, cuddling and everything, and next thing you know, it just happened, good old-fashioned make-out session.
Yes,
I like
that.
It's still alive.
A little Breyer's double churn and some Jack's Teller is going to get me good and steamed up.
There you go.
Breyer's double churn sounds dirty.
That sounds like a weird Amish sex act.
Even the old Breyer's double churn.
Even the old Breyer's double churn, if you know what I'm talking about.
Quite a cleanup process.
I've never had a hickey.
What?
I've never in my life had a hickey.
I mean, it's...
Mike, give me a hickey.
No, there's no way. God's green.
You can give him a hickey in about 2 seconds.
Oh, no, yeah,
it is.
I don't want a hickey.
It's quick.
I'm not coming home with a hickey and having to explain that to Buck and be like, oh, no, it's cool. It was a dude. No, it's okay. It was just a dude I work with.
I think I've told this story before, but...
Hickey Neck Anderson?
Of my college graduation, I may have been with a woman, and I woke up the next morning... It looked like I'd been strangled. It was that bad. It was so bad. Like, I was freaking out. Because it wasn't only the base of the neck, it went all the way up. So I had to go find a girl I knew, steal her makeup, and try to cover it all up with base for my graduation pictures.
Wendy, to the studio!
Have we gotten into technique at all? Do you have a technique when you make out? Like,
I tell
a
you
routine.
What, I'm pretty conservative. With
pretty
the
standard.
Tone. Yeah. I don't go. I don't. I'm not hitting that uvula. I've had some weird raptor makeouts where you're like, okay, I feel each one of your lips on my ears. Pull my skull out of your dumb mouth. This is way too much. Have you ever been disappointed, Wendy, in a okay, this guy's cute. Date's gone great, because that could be a first date thing. That's no big deal. Have a little makeout.
I've had bad kissers, yeah.
And then he goes to kiss, and you're like, oh, this sucks.
But when you mesh well, I like the variety. I like a, you know, little tongue, a lot of tongue. I like to go back and forth.
A little lip nibble?
Yeah, a little biting of the lip kind of thing.
Have you ever made out with a person with a huge tongue?
No, I don't think so.
No,
you'll never forget it, let me tell you.
Have you ever had a makeout session that you had planned on, you know what, I'm going to give this guy the goods, the old golden triangle, and then pulled that offer off the table because the makeout was so bad.
Yes, I've had like really bad kisser. Like when this guy would kiss me, he would lick his lips, and his lips were ultra wet, and I couldn't stand it.
Ugh.
It was like just don't lick your lips ever before you go
right,
in.
Right, and your face
just, like,
is
wetting
all
my
wet.
Whole face. Yeah.
Here it
I got
comes.
Chapped lips just from making out with you. Yeah.
Hang
so
tight.
Well, all right, here it comes.
Jesus.